some time ago, I had a friend who was in culinary school, and as one of his projects, he had to do a soft opening for his own restaurant. So he rented out this little space and laid out a menu, and as part of his project, he had to list all the ingredients and each of the things and each of the dishes. And most of it was pretty straightforward. The steak was steak, and the green beans were green beans. And as he was laying things out, he got towards the bottom, and he listed, there was this long list of chemicals or butter. And then there was this long list of chemicals or lemonade. And he listed the ingredients for butter, cream, salt. He listed the ingredients for lemonade, lemons, water, sugar. And for the diner, it was an opportunity to see exactly what you were choosing to put into your body, this long list of chemicals or these really simple ingredients. And wouldn't it be great if we were forced to confront that on a daily basis with what we choose to put into our bodies, but we also have that same opportunity about what we choose to put into our spirits and what we choose to put into our minds. And we have the opportunity to make a choice. We stand at a crossroads every day, and we have an opportunity to choose what we will do. Whether it's complicated and convoluted, or whether it's simple, honest, and pure. Today, we have an opportunity to choose that which is simple, honest, pure, true, and never failing, as opposed to that which is convoluted, that which is artificial, that which is designed to imitate but can never replicate. Today, we have the opportunity to choose God or everything else, and I choose God. This morning, we have an opportunity to make a choice that we know will lead to better health and better life, or the alternative. This morning, will you choose God? Not only this morning, but in the most difficult times of life, in the most difficult and uncomfortable situations, will you choose what is simple, what is easy, what is there, or will you choose that which is never failing?